Hello and welcome back. This is Frost Hair, and we're going to be playing some more baseball today. Yesterday we kind of got jumped into it, and we didn't really get very far with roster management and everything. So I want to just go through here and look at some stuff. Sponsorships. What do we got for sponsorships? We have a gold sponsorship. Let's put it in the in-game ticker for SSK. So there we go. Let's look. I want to change the way the our roster is set up, because yesterday we had a we have a lot of starters. I really want to keep him down. He only has one option left. I want to keep his leak. Leak has two options, and I only have him for one more year. Let's put Martin down to AAA, and let's bring up. Junior Guerra. I think that's good. That should be good for now. I realize that I don't have Jake Lamb up, but he's awful in this game. Look at that. I don't really have a backup third baseman, so I guess I'll just stay with the guys that I have now. So that's good. We do want to fix our lineups real quick. I'm just going to do the ones with no DH first, and we'll deal with DH ones later. Since we don't have a DH for the most part. Want Marte at second base. I'll probably put, this is against righties, so Calhoun can be in there. Calhoun and Marte can flip-flop. I will bring it this way. Does Carson Kelly just suck against righties? He does. Carson Kelly is ass against righties. So we'll do. We'll start vote. Here. Alright, that's good. So lefty's no DH, we gotta do the same thing. So here. Who hits better against lefties? 57-40 and 42-59. For now, I will start. What's he hit? It's 47-33. That's not great. We'll start Rojas against the lefties for now, and we'll see how that goes. I'll leave him lay down the list. I wasn't particularly pleased with Nick Ahmed last night. So I think this is probably good. There, that's probably better, I think. Yeah, that's good. That's good there. So, we'll do this. What's our pitching rotation look like? So, Gallen will start, Robbie Ray, Luke Weaver, and then I think we want to put Mike Leek in here instead of there. To get us an extra lefty. Make Archie our closer. So, this is good, I think. This should be good. This should be fine. We're fine. This is good. Yeah. So we're good. Man, Zach Gallen being only 2 points behind. We do want to update our trading block. there's a couple guys we wouldn't mind getting rid of. So if someone wants to take Mike Leake from us, they can probably. We are willing to part with Jake Lamb, Yasmine Tomas, and that's it. Free agents we got here. Yasiel Puig still a free agent. Interesting. So if we needed another outfielder, we could probably pick up Puig. That might actually not be a bad option in the coming days. This guy, I don't know who this is. I don't know why he's in the thing. He has no background whatsoever. He's just a starting pitcher that's good. Okay, that's fine then. So we should be set. Zach Duke. Like this guy. This guy's... Where does this guy come from? No, nothing ever. No background, nothing. Born in Georgia. I don't know, man. Seems weird. What's this guy's... His potential's an A. Maybe I should just sign this guy and stash him in minor league. Just for funsies. Can I sign this guy? I don't know where he came from. He only wants a 1-year contract. He has no expectations. Oh, my roster is currently full. We'll sign him later. We'll just jump into it. I'm on limited time so far, so let's simulate the day. So Diamondbacks are 1-0 now. Zach Gallen versus Cole Hamels. Let's do it. We'll play the full game. Someone asked me if they had the 2000... It doesn't look like they have the extra... the uniforms from previously. Man, they don't even have the grays anymore. The gray and teals? All they have is this, this one's alternate home here. We'll do the alternate home. I'm not going to do quick counts, but I'm probably going to be a little bit faster with it because I think I have maybe less than an hour, and I think last night's game was an hour and 20 minutes. We'll do roof open, but partly cloudy today. Overcast. It's overcast here in Arizona today. Broadcast style, the show theme, of course. Zach Gallen, lovely. We just set this up, so we'll go with this starting lineup. So how was, I hope everyone had a good day today. We'll get started with this. Today was more of the same in terms of how everything's being handled. I'll try not to get into too many opinions on stuff, just because we are under the lights as the show gets everyone's entitled to their opinion. You think people are doing the right thing, people are doing the wrong thing. It's a thing. It's a thing that happens, and it's okay. It's okay that next on the show. It's okay if you think people are doing the right thing, or people are doing the wrong thing, or whatever you want to do. It's okay. This guy had a real solid season last year. ERA under 3. Let's get started. So Zach Gallen, 3-6 last year, 2.81 ERA. Let's see if we can't get him a good. Ooh, that presentation down there is hot. It'll be interesting to see how he pitches in this one today. I don't know if I noticed that yesterday, but that presentation down on the corner is good. Is looking good. Well, guys, you take a look the home at the teals are the best. I like the gray teals. I think those are the home teals are the best.
Yeah, Maddie, I know it's a long season, but
the gray teals. I can't even think straight. I'm so bad at it. The gray teal uniforms are the best uniforms. Another win here. There's no doubt about it. Those are the best. With that being said, those don't exist anymore. Temperature here at game time, 61 degrees. And so the best we have is the white teals. What do I want to throw? Let's throw the knuckle curve. I know I was saying that I was like, oh yeah, I gotta kind of speed through this, and then I'm gonna sit here and like take 10 minutes of this out of pitch. Alive, putting together a really good at bat here. It's a little warm already here in Arizona, so. That was a terrible pitch. Why would you swing at that, Ozzy Albies? Boy, he's having a hard time just putting the ball in play right now. That was terrible. Hat trick with three strikeouts yesterday. I'll take it. Zach Gallen, take it. Looks to me like he just needs to simplify his approach and focus on making. There's no reasonable explanation for why you swung at that. So, all right. He's getting everything. It's not that changeup. It's just going like it's sticking inside, even though like I'm hitting pretty consistent in the marker or the meter. Are you going to talk about it? From game to game. Away. Yeah, he can be a little inconsistent, Dan. No question about it. But he's approachable.
Ooh, in the dirt.
As an offensive player, I just want to be able to turn around and say, is that as far as you're going today? And Woody will usually give you
nice. So two strikeouts for Gallen so far. He's on a mission. To at least put the ball in play here this Every pitcher is always on a mission to throw a perfect game. Fastball just misses. Freddie Freeman has spent his entire career with Atlanta. That's a fun fact of the day. Let's see. I'm throwing the changeup away.
That evens it
see,
up.
That
one
stayed.
One.
But for some reason, I'm trying to throw it inside. It's drifting so far inside. It's like he's losing it midway through that release. No, that's the ball. I've noticed they are much better today about laying off of stuff.
This is a good at
I mean, they
so
still have inexplicably,
if
you know,
go down
swinging
one,
at the changeup that basically hits him.
He's doing
see, that
he's
one too. That was just, I had a bad out, release on it, but it just, that changeup, when he lets it go, it just flies inside.
Pulls this one into the air, out into right field. Back goes Rojas. He gets there
took
to
a
make
bad,
the catch.
Took a bad break on that ball.
Down in order go the Braves. And now the Diamondbacks.
All right, cool. 3 minute first half inning.
Digging in now.
Five minute first half inning. Jeez.
Lead things off here in the bottom half of the
Starling Marte. I don't think he got a hit yesterday. Yeah, Ben Ofer. See in the top, in the background of that screen. Zeros across the board.
Out on the wrong foot, dropping one on the road on opening day. Yeah, Maddie, they need to grab this
not
one.
Not anymore. Get down.
Two games in a season. I don't care if it's on the road. I know you're going to have
push it for that double.
Play well at home.
Nice. He's wearing teal batting gloves. I don't know if that's part of the that's a weird part of the uniform. Either that or it's just like it's such a weird part of the uniform. To start off the inning.
And that'll bring in the middle infielder Ketel Marte. Hamels has pitched his way to over 2,600 innings of work at the big league level.
Sleeping,
and through those innings, he's worked to a whip under 1.20. League average is around 1.3, so that's a respectable number. Ozuna is there, and he has it for the out.
Probably going to be in that
and
right
the
now.
The runner, not tagging, will retreat to second base. David Peralta. He also had three hits in the win last night. Good lead there at second. Here's the pitch.
Oof.
First pitch cutter that's by him for
right.
Strike one.
David Peralta Marte was acquired via free agency. I feel like that's not right. I mean, maybe they did, But I was pretty certain that he got cut. Like, isn't the story that he was a pitcher for, like, the Cardinals or something? And then got cut, I thought. Because he had his shoulder messed up? Maybe he's got let out of his contract or something? And then he went to play in, like, the Mexican League? As an outfielder? I mean, that I may be remembering that wrong, but that's what I'm remembering.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. Line drive to center field.
Scoreless into the first, even though we had a runner in scoring position.
Great job there of working out of potential trouble. One left for the Diamondbacks. We are still scoreless. Now in the box, Ronald Acuna.
I'm really intrigued by the way this changeup is going, so I'm going to throw so many changeups today.
Swing and a miss as he was way in front of that one.
Acuna was signed out of Venezuela. I like that touch to this. It tells you like how they got there. Or at least two with the team, because it's telling me Freddie Freeman, what tells us earlier, Freddie Freeman has been with Atlanta for his entire career, 10 seasons.
He's really a rare talent in this sport, a true five-tool player, as they say, which means he can make an impact in a game at any time. Really a joy
something
to
is
watch,
humming,
not someone
buzzing.
You want to take your eye off.
I think it's our water
machine.
Yeah,
this guy's worth the price of a ticket. Just
it's
to
in
watch
the next
his
room over.
Set, but not only that, the way he grinds at the plate, the way he battles defensively, this guy is one of the true superstars in our game.
It's telling me he wants to throw the changeup. That gallon's like, let's do this. Changeup in the dirt.
Challenge right
feels
here.
High heat.
Not want to run the count
I'm gonna cut her away. So he can hit it. Oh! That was beautiful. That was perfect. That was as perfect as it gets.
Into the box now.
Marcelo Zuna was 1-for-3 yesterday.
Now here's the pitch.
So I mean, again, we're talking about how
the
difficulty will change
the wind up
throughout
and the 0-1.
The game over the next couple of games. I really probably should have done quick counts. I think we're going to run into a time constraint here, where I'm going to have to start zooming through like the second half of this game. I really don't want to do that.
You hear the pop of the glove all the way up here.
Hey, I admit I'm a little biased. There's nothing better than that pop of a glove.
Another strikeout.
Looking forward to hearing a lot more of that pop the rest of this one.
So he sets him down swinging. Marcelo Zuna is sent packing for out number 2 in the inning. And the 34-year-old veteran looks at a called strike. It's 0-1.
Carson Kelly and Carson Kelly hates Zach Allen. He just cannot catch him today. There's so many drop balls back there.
This pitcher's bringing it with some high velo. You better get that
a low cutter, probably not the best pitch.
He's gonna throw it right by you.
2 balls and 2 strikes now to the Braves catcher.
That buzzing is my phone.
And just a masterful job of pitching here as he strikes out the side in order. 3 up, 3 down, 3 strikeouts. Not too shabby. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on the show. Stepping up to the plate, Christian Walker. He went deep last night twice.
Christian Walker went deep twice last night. Let's see if he can do it again. Oof.
And he fouls this one off.
Lead on a fastball.
Once a member of the Chicago Cubs organization, he was signed as a free agent in the middle of last season.
Yeah, I know he expected to get a longer-term deal, but these are the facts right now. He is on a 1-year deal, and he is going to have to produce.
Man,
if he is going to get
Walker
that
is apparently not as good as he was last night.
Hit on the ground out to short.
See, and the game has somewhat adjusted already, I think, in terms of hitting, particularly my style of hitting. Just because
so striding in Nick Ahmed as he'll get his first opportunity in this one.
I'm not great at being patient. like that, I probably shouldn't have swung at that. I'm also kind of in a hurry. That's obviously bad to do when I'm streaming and trying to play a baseball game. But, get out of play, Or get down, I guess. I tend to swing at a lot of junk.
Hot shot on the ground is short.
Ooh, that was close. I'm gonna almost beat that out.
Coming to the plate now, Carson Kelly. It was a three-hit effort from him last night, so he was a big part of that victory. Drilled on the
Another ground ball. Man, that is a bummer. It's a bummer.
Digging in, Charlie Culberson. He starts off the inning against a guy who struck out the side last inning. How did they get to him here?
I'm not sure, Matt, that they want to stay as patient. He's been throwing a lot of strikes. They might want to start swinging a little
bit earlier.
The windup and the 1-0 pitch. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Peralta is under it. One away.
See, Zach Gallen's already up to 32 pitches in three innings.
Standing in,
their guy's probably at like nine. through two innings, he's probably at like 12 pitches. Austin Riley, first round pick. I was not aware of that. Baseball's so weird with the way that picks work. I think it's such a crapshoot in most cases. Which guys are going to pan out, which guys are going to put in the work, which guys are going to, you know, do all this insane stuff. You got a guy like Dansby Swanson, who was number one pick. He made it up to the majors pretty good because he's got all the tools, but is he improving? Then you got Paul Goldschmidt was like a 15-round pick. And he's like one of the best players in baseball. And I got him.
So you
really gotta think about that. Like, baseball draft is so difficult, and I think it's because there's so much teaching that goes in to
third inning, no score to this point.
The game. You know, it's kind of not necessarily like football. Football, I think, is the next best kind of relatable sport, because you got, you know, guys in baseball seem to just come out of nowhere. Guys in football, some of the greats in football have seemed to come out of nowhere. Tom Brady is the obvious example, but you got guys that are good, like they come out of the fifth round, sixth round all the time.
Tough curveball that
just
time,
like
but he's able
high
to
school
make a little
recruiting
contact
for colleges. You got guys that are two-star players
that
are winning awards. J.J. Watt was a walk-on. I don't know what he was ranked in high school, but he was a walk-on. In baseball, it's even more. Maybe it's just because there's so many different people. There's more players. More of a system. More people are given a shot.
Ready now, Josh.
Maybe that's
Rojas,
what it is.
As we move on to the bottom of inning number three.
I don't know.
Here's the first pitch to him.
But it just seems like you have, what, pick up 40 players in the draft every year, potentially.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Sharp ground ball.
Ooh, nice. That's good because then I can bunt him over with Gallen.
Hey, right here, anytime the leadoff hitter gets on in front of the pitcher, puts the defense on notice.
You're going to see 20 to 25 new players trying to get the draft
at second base, but if not, make sure of one.
And most of them
into the box. Zach Gallen drops one down here, and he'll try to beat it out.
Chances on that one as this is scooped away in foul territory. I don't understand how the bunting works. I think if I, like, so if I just try to push it towards.
On its way, the 0-1 pitch. And the
there we
pitcher
go.
Is in fact bunting.
That's better.
Here as he puts this one
so
down.
You push which side you want to bunt with first, and then you bunt, and then you move the bat around. So if you go to bunt, you push which way you want to bunt first, and then you move the bat whichever direction afterwards.
looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the
so
pitches you only get. Maybe once
Starling Marte.
Game,
I think they
game,
only have him for 1 year, I think. Or is it
so
two? I can't remember. I think it's just one.
Time.
I think this is the last year of his contract.
Hard to short. Oh, and he can't come up with it. Throw goes to third. And he is out, retreating to second.
Oh,
ha.
That was my fault. I sent him. I thought he would be. I thought he would be ahead of the play, and crap. Well, you know. You live and you learn. Try to go yard with Marte here, but also send the other Marte.
Runners off for second, and it's fouled away. Ready with the nothing in one pitch. He's on the move again from first.
Oh, that's probably a regular fly out, I think.
Mark
yep. A little late on it. I wasn't expecting. I thought it was going to be a breaking ball.
So up steps Ozzie Albies back to the top of the lineup as they're still.
Anyways, I don't know. I just think that it's such a crapshoot. I don't even want to say it's a crapshoot because I feel like that's bad too. Because like obviously there's some kind of science behind it. In other words, you wouldn't like a lot of guys that are good are drafted first, like that's obviously. But I think there's crapshoot's a bad word. I think there's a lot more wiggle room for a guy to rise up and be good when they weren't drafted.
Here now the 2-2.
And I think so much of that is luck based. I know there's a lot of skill involved with baseball, but I also think there's a small meter of luck involved as well. And that's just because if so you can say X, Y, and Z about how much ability you have to recognize the ball and all that nonsense coming out of the hand, but you also have to have a good feel for, you have to have a good feel for, I don't want to say this. I don't know what I'm trying to say. there's a little luck involved, you know? There's a ton of talent. Don't get me wrong. There's a ton of talent and skill. I feel like there's also a little bit of luck involved. RNG, if you will. There's nothing wrong with that. That's good reasonable. I might be dropping frames because my computer is acting up. It's like not registering the internet on Twitch. So I will verify that I'm not dropping any frames. I'm dropping a shit ton of frames. That's not good. Dropping more frames by the second, actually.
Now the 1-0.
I don't know why that is.
It's a breaking ball that misses off the plate.
6.4%. Frames, dropping frames left and right. And now he's put himself in a real. I don't know that there's very much I can do about that other than reset maybe the internet after this to see if we can stop it for later on.
If he had the green light here.
But yeah, frames are just
I know he's got the green light
here.
He's looking for something set or cut and he's looking to do damage.
So I apologize if
you're
getting a lot of bad
one.
Feedback.
Gotta believe he had the green light in that situation.
Hopefully
two
it's
outs,
just a
3-0 count. This
a
guy can certainly
in our
handle
internet.
A bat. That's a perfect situation to let him loose. But I love the fact that he's keyholing a certain area and it wasn't what he was looking
gone
for.
Gone through three and a half innings, what? Right?
The payoff pitch home.
In about.
Popped up Escobar in foul ground.
Yeah, we got him on.
And
though.
This is gonna wind up a foul ball. No runs, no hits, and one.
They got a
on
shift on for him,
so. Down the first baseline.
reined in. Got it. Nice and easy there.
Step on the bag himself, and the inning is
we're still
over.
Dropping a ton of frames. I don't like it very much at all. And it's not... I think it's just streaming frames. So it might be Twitch. It could be the internet, I don't know. But yeah, just frames left and right. So maybe, I mean, I'm still recording this for...
You'd think by now one of these two teams would be able to get some space runners on to get in.
I'm going to stop streaming and keep recording, and I'll be back in a second. If you're watching this on YouTube, I guess, then it won't matter because you'll see the full video.
So the base is empty here with one away, and that'll bring up Eduardo Escobar.
I don't know if I can stop streaming without stopping recording, actually, so I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to let it go as it lies.
Lofted in the air out toward right center.
Man.
Marquez has a read on it.
Cole Hamels is at 24 pitches. I think Zach Gallen was at 40 something.
Stepping up now.
This is why quick counts, because see if I'm swinging it like the first thing, then quick counts really helps because, like, I swing at that garbage when I strike out, but, like, also. I'm swinging
like
at junk.
Start working the count a little bit more and drive up this pitcher's pitch count.
Scooped up.
And he still,
throw to first, we'll get
it still shows that he's throwing like four pitches.
D-backs are down on four pitches. Through four, still tied. Nothing
okay, my drop frames went down. I don't know if it just reset itself or something. There's a big delay though. I wonder if my internet's taking a hit.
Check in with Heidi Watney.
Probably is.
Matt,
it's
I
storming
had a chance
out
to discuss
right
the Braves
now.
Offense with their manager Brian Snicker during the commercial break, and he told me overall he's not happy.
So
with the
we'll keep an eye on it. I'll reset my internet after this game.
So it's starting to feel
just to try to get through this.
Here. But he said they've unfortunately just been faced with some really great pitching today. The key going
yes,
forward
Zach
is to find
at 60
any way they can to get him out of his rhythm on the mound. Now that may be a tall task, but they feel the little.
And some of that was, I think, I was when I was talking. The last two innings, I think I got up to some pretty high counts and pitches.
And he struck him out. Struck
I wasn't
out
focusing specifically on
now
pitching
Marcelo Zuna
and being good, which I mean happens.
He went down on strikes in his first at-bat.
We got a nice little pitcher's duel going on here.
No runs, no hits, and one error on the Atlanta line score. Hard on the ground towards short. And that's the first hit in this one for the Braves.
Man, first hit. I didn't even realize they hadn't gotten a hit yet. Whoops.
Here now is the catcher, Tyler Flowers. Hit in the air to left field. After it is Peralta.
Oh. There we go.
He tracks it down and makes the play to record the save.
Man, I'm not focused right now. Because I was like, in the middle of that, I was like, I heard the cat. And I was like, stop, cat. And now, then I didn't realize I had to throw the ball back in.
First pitch of the at bat.
Culberson.
Outside that time, as the breaking ball can't catch the zone.
He struck out twice last night. He sucks.
Fouled off.
No, I'm sure he's a nice guy.
Now the 1-1 pitch.
I don't know. I always find that like weird, like. It's nice to talk smack and everything, but, like, I don't know who he is.
He
probably has a family, probably tries really hard, works hard, maybe. I don't know, maybe he does a lot of steroids. Who knows? Nah, I don't know. Maybe. Drink some water.
Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the commercial break, I had a chance to catch up with manager Torey Lovello about the Diamondbacks' offensive production, and he told me that they have to find a way to be more patient at the plate.
Have to find a way to be more patient at the plate. That is exactly right.
And while
you are exactly right, Missy.
That's clearly not the case right now.
My difficulty decreased because I suck so much.
Swing on the first pitch, and a lot of those have resulted in swinging misses or outs, guys.
Another ground out, man.
Okay, thank you,
it looks good. It's right down the middle of the plate. I don't know what you want me to do about that. Hey, look at that. That was right down the middle. Swing was good. Contact was good.
Oh.
I don't know what you want me to do about that. I don't know what you want me to do about that. I literally don't know. There we go. There we go. Now we need Rojas in.
You don't get too many touches a day in
Nick Ahmed. Nick Ahmed isn't slow. Some of the stats.
Standing in, Josh Rojas. He singled his last time up. Now a chopper to first might only get one. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. And they tag him out.
Some of these stats.
Sort of a sacrifice as the runner moves up.
I just don't get them. Like the ratings. I don't think Nick Ahmed's slow, but for him to have a 20, it's ridiculous. Here goes Zach Gallen. Can make your give yourself a win right here. Get a hit. Cat, knock it off.
He's rolling so far in this one as we head in the middle part of this game. How about 90% of his first pitches have been for strikes?
Or maybe not. Maybe Zach Gallen's going to strike out.
And the 0-2. Line
get out. Oh, man.
What a play that time as that ball had extra bases.
Heartbreaker. Heartbreaker.
They'll try and get things started.
I'm going to let Zach Gallen go as long as he can tonight because he's got the
first pitch of the inning is taken down.
He's got a one-hitter going, I guess. I'll probably take him out. This will probably be his last inning.
Right side. And a good effort on the dive
might,
time, but
might
this will
give up
him for
more
a
than
a
leadoff single.
Standing in now, Cole Hamels. Squaring around now is Hamels as he puts this one down. Throw's going to go on to first, so a perfect sacrifice.
Oh, nice. I like that. I kind of ran away from the back, but here. I like that a lot.
Runner at second, one away.
Oh, come on, Blue. Give me that one. He struck out three times last night. Come on. Can't tell me he's not going to strike out again right here.
Line drive to center field. Marte is back, and he'll get there to make the play for route number two. The throw is wild, and he gets away.
I threw to the cutoff man, and there was no cutoff man. I got really nervous there for a second. Where's my team at?
He struck out and grounded out in his first two tries. Fastball in there.
All right, Zach.
Shocked he didn't let it fly right there.
Prove
usually
yourself
you're
here.
Looking for a fastball elevated to get the ball
nice.
Started.
In there at the knees.
I like it. Let's throw a knuckle curve in the dirt.
Boy, this is one of those ABs you like to hit the rewind button on. Put himself in a tough spot now, hitting with two strikes.
Count is one and two now.
Change up away. I like your
one
thinking, Carson.
Two, here it is.
Got him.
Strike him out.
Perfect.
Now in the ball game, and the inning is over. One left for Atlanta, and this is still a nothing-nothing ball.
Perfect.
Bottom of the sixth inning now.
It's a tie game, so I'm going to put Alex Young in the bullpen as our long reliever.
Here comes the first pitch.
Ah.
Oh, and he can't pick it
man,
up
their team sucks at fielding. Holy shit, that's like the down. Third drop ball. Things have moved around. Move a little bit. Quicker than the next that three innings. First three seemed like it was going to be. Pop up. Or routine fly ball, whatever you call it. What are you going to call it? I was late. Cole Amos is going to be through six innings with less than 40 pitches. Look at the beginner difficulty, the batting difficulty is just dying. Cole Amos is just fucking eating me up.
Soft liner towards short.
That was bad. She missed one of that. That was a bad pitch.
Throw on to first, a three-pitch inning. And the side
a three-pitch inning. You're right. You're right. You're absolutely right.
Next up will be Freddie Freeman.
I'm going to give Zach Gallen a little bit more of a leash here.
Yeah, I'll agree with that, Matt. That's what you kept on both starting pitchers. Have it working. Neither of them have been nibbling around the strike zone at all, and they've trusted their defense to make the plays, and they've done just that.
He's just not getting the calls. I mean, that one was pretty off, but he had a couple other ones that were pretty close that he didn't get. Like, they were like that.
One and two now.
Changeup away. Got him. Strikeout number 11.
The great equalizer, the changeup. That was a really good job of getting him to offer
nice.
That one out of the zone, and it was all set up.
See, like that one. That one's right there on the border. He's not getting the call.
That's the name of the game.
The 1-0 is swung on and missed. Strike one.
Acuna. If anyone's gonna like. This is one of those games where, like, I'm going to let him go too long, he's going to give up a home run, and I'm going to get shut out. Like, that's how it always happens. That's, like, my first loss of any season. That's exactly how it happens. It's, like, it's a shutout, and then, like, I'm going to be all like, oh, well, yeah, he's got a no-hitter going, or he's got a one-hitter. Might as well let him just keep going. And then all of a sudden, it's like, their pitcher hit a home run, and you can't hit the ball out of the infield. Congratulations. That was actually why I started doing it. Like, I was really happy about quick counts in the beginning. Because, like, I don't mind pitching. I like pitching. I like mixing everything up. I like having the freedom to throw a ball that's, like, complete junk and not be pressured. But I'm not patient at all in batting. I'm not patient one bit.
13
strikeouts for Zach Gallen, and that's going to be the end for him because we're gonna go to the over right
here.
Difficulty decreased in batting again. Jesus, There we go. See, when the difficulty decreases, they start throwing it down the middle again.
Single, and maybe now they can start.
You're 1,000% going to try to hit this long ball, Christian Walker.
Tactics, not always the play. You want to drive that,
so you are as a person.
Bullpen, but sometimes
get down. Didn't get enough of you. Good contact. Good timing. Okay contact.
Ready once
smaller
again,
man.
Nick Ahmed. He was retired via the ground ball last
bummer.
Time.
Bummer.
Expect this pitcher to try and get the same result as his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
I couldn't tell if it was going to get down.
Carson Kelly.
Come on, two hits is all I need.
Hamels comes set. Here's the first pitch. Line toward the alley in left center. And he dives to make a spectacular catch. What a play there.
Man, that would have scored Escobar easy.
That would have scored Escobar.
Definitely.
Digging in once again, Tyler Flowers will start us off in the eighth.
Well, they got all righties, though. Just get him, I guess. Get him ready and waiting. I'm gonna give up a home run. Yes.
On a less than impressive swing there to start the at bat. It's 0-1.
Like, I know it.
You never want to take the.
I almost feel like I shouldn't put Alex Young in at all now because.
I'd like to see the leadoff guy.
Now it's the eighth inning.
Down a little bit more, especially when this pitcher's missing like he is.
Now it looks like the Braves are gonna get a lefty up and throwing in their bullpen.
Yeah, I mean, this is going to be one of those games where it's like, I'm like, yeah, I need to get done with this, and then it's going to go to like 14 runs, and then 1-0. Once I get to extras, like, extras are really bad for me, because once I get to extras and I'm the home team, I'm just like, walk-off time, start launching home run balls, power swing. You got a guy that's like never hit a home run in his life. And I'm all like, yeah, power swing. No, this guy, his first home run ever is going to be, you know, first home run ever, he's going to.
Oh,
get it. Turn two. Yeah. We're going to the bottom of the eighth. It's home run time. I need to. Archie is stretching, so he's good. So for some reason,
this is hit the other way out toward left
right
field.
At Rojas.
There to handle it is Ozuna, and there's one away.
Did he just throw that underhand in? What? Let's see. Cole Hamels is a lefty, so someone with good contact against lefties is going to be Vargas.
Ildemaro Vargas will grab a bat.
Ildemaro. Difficulty decreased again, guys. And I grounded out my first pitch. Jesus Christ. Fucking awful. I know I said I watched my language, but it's so bad. And I'm still dropping frames left and right. The game's like, is this someone else playing? Because this isn't the same guy who played yesterday. That wasn't a power swing, by the way. That was just me trying to pull it. Get down. See, perfect timing, perfect fly ball. There's, like, I don't know what you want me to do, man. We're gonna put. I guess we're putting Archie in the game. Sit Rondon down.
Archie Bradley.
Yeah, I mean, he wasn't fully ready, but sure. I'm probably gonna lose because of this. Because Archie's 1,000% gonna be a home run right now. Like, I can almost guarantee it. Rondon needs to still be up.
And a good idea to hold off on the swing. It's ball one. And it's fouled away.
Just because I'm not going to pitch Archie two innings in a row, so someone has to pitch next inning. I won't bring in. I'll get Alex Young back up after the 10th.
Just able to get a piece of that for strike.
Whatever the pitcher spot comes back around, since I just batted with Ildemaro. I mean, Marte launching a home run here in the bottom of the 9th is just going to end it anyways, right? So, no need to worry. Let's see how this changeup works. Archie's changeup went right. I don't know. There's got to be something in there, because that was a perfect, it was a perfect release point. Oh, maybe I'm not, I don't even know if I'm doing the meter right. This is how I've always done the meter, and so I'm kind of like used to it, and I feel like it's successful for me. Is you just hold it till you get all the way to the end, and then you hit the marker as you're coming back. So you hold it, and then you release, and then you press again. That's what I'm doing. If I'm doing it wrong, please let me know. I'll probably not be able to fix it because I'm terrible. Let's see, like, if I hold it, if I just like press it, see, it doesn't fill up. Maybe that's what you're supposed to do. I don't know. Like, I tapped it twice instead of holding it twice. But I don't know. I'll look at it next time. Next time I pitch, we'll see. Mark Melanson's coming in. Get the save. Tell Marte he's played like shit all game. Difficulty and back to beginner. Back where we began. Get.
That's
early.
That's
1-for-5 versus Melanson. Melancone. Yeah, Mark Melanson. What am I talking about? Melancone. Get out. Get out. Walk off, baby. Let's go.
Game over. Walk off home run.
Woo! That's awesome. And I told you that was going to happen, too. We tanked. We did this, guys. We knew we were going to win 1-0. We tanked the difficulty. Hitting a bunch of garbage all game. They shouldn't have taken Cole Hamels out. That's all I'm saying. They should have left Cole Hamels in. Archie Bradley gets the win.
That's obviously something that he takes to heart as he
Archie Bradley gets the win, guys.
Gotta be the best feeling in all of baseball.
I just want to watch the replay, man. It's gone. Well, Ketel Marte now has two home runs to tie in with Christian Walker. There you go. I mean, he's got to get player of the game, right? Or is it Zach Gallen? Who gets it? Is it Marte or Gallen? Marte or Gallen? I'm going to go with Marte. It's got to be, right? Well, we watched a really they give it to Zach Gallen. Nice. The opposition at bay, and I mean, eight shutout innings. That's pretty good. Player of the game.
Well, when you rack up a whole boatload of strikeouts like he did here, there's
eight shutout innings. He was fun to watch. Oh, he had 13 strikeouts. I forgot about that. Next time. Only gave up three hits. 14 strikeouts. Good Lord.
One run held up tonight, 1-0 the final. Arizona came through when it mattered in the ninth on the way to the win. Archie Bradley.
So Arizona has not given up a single run yet. That's a wrap here tonight. Nice. Like, see, notables there. Ketel Marte. He's that, like, but it doesn't give me the MVP stats here. Silly. What does this manage? Can handle all your team's roster needs. Okay, don't care about that. Acquisitions, contracts, coaching contracts. Knowing your coaching staff is important as a coach. You can see how it affects your team. So Tori Lovello apparently is a bad... Man, I have a lot of coaches that suck. Johnny Sargent, though, good. These guys are not great. I probably need to hire new guys. Dave McKay as bad stealing. Is there any guys that, like, speed? -3 power? Come on, we want more power. Home runs, man. This guy. Tony Perez Chica +2 in speed is fantastic. Seeing as how half my team is slow as shit. Chris Bryant is a free draft this year. I might sign Chris. If we keep playing this, I might sign Chris Bryant. Where's my contracts? That's what I want. Escobar's got two left. He's under team control, though. I hate, like, how it doesn't tell you. Like, I guess you kind of have to understand how movie service works, but it doesn't tell you, like, under team control for X amount of years. What's on our... Who's on our roster that we gotta get rid of? Crichton? I don't want him down. Does he not count? Probably not. Or is it my 40 man that I have to take players off of if I want to sign that guy? Fuck this guy, release him. Sucks. There. Now I can. Oh, there he is. Yeah, I see that. He dropped? Is this guy gonna be one of the guys that, like, sucks? Like, he's just. It's just. Artificially, like, because my scouting is bad. Okay, so he should have went on my 40 man. Where's he at? Go to pitchers. So he's in AAA. He's not on the 40 man. He's better than Alex Young, Weaver, Mike Leake, and Corbin Martin. I think Luke Weaver is really good. I think he's going to be fantastic. The AAA roster is stacked. I was talking with a friend earlier today about this Duplantier thing. Like, I don't understand why, like, what they have against him. But here we are. I really want to pick up Puig. I really want to. because I don't have an extra outfielder. And Rojas did okay. 2-for-5 on the season. Cole Calhoun's 0-for-4. But at least he's got a high average. What I really need is some depth. Some farm depth in the outfield that's not these two guys. I assume Kelsey player card. They can both play the whole outfield though, so in theory, both of these guys will probably play together. Both in double A. Probably much triple A sometimes. Alec Thomas, this guy, can he play everything too? Yep. So this is the outfield of the future, these three guys right here. And they're mostly all speed guys. No power tools. Anyways, that'll be it for us today. We will advance the day. And tomorrow we go for the series. No, we don't go for the series. Tomorrow we go for the series win. Robbie Ray versus Max Fried. We have another lefty-lefty battle. Let's look to see. Ooh, look at that. D-backs, Dodgers, Padres, all 2-0. Let's look at home run leaders after two games.
Free agent starting pitcher number 31 has agreed to terms on a one-year deal with the organization.
Pete Alonso.
The Dodgers held the opposition at
look at those power numbers. Holy crap.
The visiting Giants 3-1. Tommy Pham.
That's got to be broken, right?
Day, driving in 5 on 3 hits.
Holy cow.
The Rockies 10-5. The Phillies took down the Fish in Miami 2-1. The Blue Jays racked up 11 hits as a team as they beat the visiting Red Sox 4-3. The Minnesota Twins.
I was looking to see if there's any power numbers even close. Bellinger.
They defeated the A's in Oakland 3-2.
Muncie.
The Rangers totaled 13 hits as a team as they bested the Mariners in Safeco Field 7-6.
That's gotta be a bug.
The Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim grabbed 13 hits
there's
in the
no
game
way
as they got a win over the Astros.
Holy
in
crap, Pete Alonso.
As always, thanks for tuning in. That's all
nice
we got this morning.
Well, nice.
Enjoy the games later today, and we'll see you tomorrow.
So, all right, I will talk to you guys later. I'll talk to you guys later.